Welcome back to the part 2 of this tutorial. The first thing that you can notice is that the size of the head and neck is too short. So we'll go ahead and change that from the modify panel. Let's go to the neck section over here and increase the neck height slider. So this looks good, and we'll also increase the scale of the head. We can see that there are some deformations at the neck and back of the head. This could have been easily fixed during the first part of the tutorial where we have to select the effective area, but that's fine. We'll fix that over here using the Edit Mesh option in the Modify panel. So we'll go to the Sculpt option over here and select the Smooth tool. Increase the brush size over here and start relaxing some of the faces to reduce the deformations. Let's go back to the neck sliders over here and let's increase the width and depth of the neck. Now let's check some of the facial expressions for this character. We can see that there are some issues with the mouth over here. This is because we tried to align the points of the human lips on an animal. Let's go back to the Edit Mesh option and try to relax the faces for the lips. This looks fine. And now let's go to the lip slider and reduce the scale of the lips. This looks better. Let's go to the lip seam sliders and reduce the depth of the lip seams. We can also hide the lips over here by using these two sliders in the lip seam. The first one is lip upper inner close open, where the inner part of the lips we can move it upwards by increasing this slider. And the other one is lip lower inner close open, which we need to reduce to hide the lower part of the lips. This looks better. Let's go back to the neutral expression. And you can see there is some issue over here just below the mouth. So that is nothing but the tongue. So because this is not a human character, the tongue placement is not correct. Let's go to the Edit Mesh option and move the tongue faces inside. And now let's select an expression where the tongue is clearly visible. And with this expression on, we can go back to the Edit Mesh and move the tongue faces inside. Let's select another expression with disgust, where the mouth is being exaggerated a lot. And let's Edit Mesh and fix the mouth over here as well. So this way, you can try out all the different expressions that you're going to use for your project and try to fix that as much as possible by repeating the same process. Let's try to match the body with the head. So let's go to the full body sliders over here and increase the body thin slider. This looks better. And now we'll work on the eyes. So I want to increase the scale of the iris. So let's go to the headshot slider in actor parts and increase the iris scale. Let's also increase the scale of the pupil. Let's change the expression to closed eyes to see if the eyes are aligned properly. So you can see that the eyes are extruding out. So let's fix that. Let's go to the eye section in the headshot sliders and search for eyeball. First, let's increase the height of the eyes and reduce the width so the eyes get closer to the nose. And now let's decrease the eyes depth so the eyes would go inside. And now let's go back to the facial expressions and let's close the eyes and check. This looks much better. And now let's give some clothing to this character. I'm going to use this character for a personal project where the character does martial arts. So I have purchased this kimono pack from Reillusion Marketplace. I'll leave the link in the description. So let's add some of the clothing from this pack. And just to make this cooler, let's use the SkinGen plugin to add some tattoos on his face. So this tribe warrior looks really cool. So let's add that on this character. Let's permanently flatten all the makeup onto the texture of the character. This looks way better. And now let's add a talking animation to check the facial expressions. This looks good. And that's how you can create a humanoid cat using the Headshot plugin for Character Creator. As this is my first time creating these tutorials, please leave some feedback in the comment section. I'll have a look and try to make it better for the next tutorial. Thanks for watching.